Hello, cyber citizens. Welcome to AVK classes. This is Decoding Concepts. In this section, we explain different concepts so that you will become even more smarter and can outsmart others. So stay tuned to get smarter. And don't forget to flex the brain muscles, because we are going to get started. Heisenberg's uncertainty principle is one of the major principles of quantum physics and has found a way to our day-to-day life. It says that we can never measure the exact position and exact speed of a moving object simultaneously. This uncertainty can be explained using a simple theory. When we try to measure the position of a moving object, it causes some change in its speed, and vice versa. But the real reason behind this is much deeper and interesting. Uncertainty principle exists because everything in the universe behaves both as a particle and a wave at the same time. In quantum mechanics, an object doesn't have any exact position nor does it have an exact speed. In order to understand better, we need to understand the properties of wave and particle. A particle by definition exists at a single place at any instant in time. We can easily point out its location with the help of coordinates. Whereas wave, on the other hand, are disturbances that spread out in space like ripples on the surface of the water. We can identify the features of the wave pattern as a whole. Most importantly, its wavelength. But we can't assign a single position to wave because wave as a whole has a good probability of being in lots of different places. Wavelength is important in quantum physics since the object's wavelength is related to its momentum. Momentum is quantity expressed as a product of mass and velocity. A fast-moving object has high momentum due to its speed, which corresponds to a very short wavelength. Also, a massive object too have high momentum due to its mass, even if it is not moving very fast, which also means shorter wavelength. This is the reason we don't notice the wave nature of day-to-day objects. The wavelength of a cricket ball when tossed is a billionth of a trillionth of a trillionth of a meter, which is far too tiny to ever detect. But small things like atoms or electrons can have wavelengths big enough to measure in physics experiments. So if we have a pure wave, we can measure its wavelength and thus its momentum. But as said, it has no position. So the dilemma here is that we can measure the position of a particle, but it has practically no wavelength. Thus, we can't measure its momentum. So in order to get a particle with both position and momentum, we need to combine both the pictures. We can do this by superimposing waves of different wavelengths. As we superimpose, we find at some places the peaks add up to form bigger peaks, and peaks of some fill in the valleys of other. As a result, we see regions of waves separated by regions of nothing. On adding few more waves, the regions where waves cancel out become bigger. The peak increases and the wavier regions becoming narrower. If we keep on adding waves, we can make a wave packet with a clear wavelength in one small region. This is quantum object, one with both particle and wave nature. But by accomplishing this, we have lost both position and momentum certainty. That means the position of this quantum wave packet is not restricted to a single point. Since there is a good probability of finding this wave packet within some range of the center of the wave packet. Also, the wave packet is made by adding lots of waves, so the packet may have momentum corresponding to any one of the added waves. Thus, the position and momentum are uncertain and they are inversely proportional. That means if you want to reduce the position uncertainty, you will have to add more waves to the packet, thus increasing the momentum uncertainty. And if you want to reduce the momentum uncertainty, then you need to reduce the number of waves, that means a bigger wave packet, increasing position uncertainty. That's what you call Heisenberg's uncertainty principle, first stated by Werner Carl Heisenberg back in 1927. Hope you liked the video. If you do, please hit the thumbs up button to let us know. please comment below if you have any comments, suggestions and ideas for future videos. Don't forget to subscribe to AVK Classes because we make videos every week. And please to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we post a new video. You can follow us on Twitter. Also, like our Facebook page. All the links are provided below in the description. Thank you for watching. Hope this video created a spark in your gray cells and helped you to understand the intricacies. We will meet again soon with another video. Till then, stay curious and keep learning. Thank you.